So proudly we hailed. good food with attitude. So no matter if you come early or late night, at Maddie's Diner, you're always family.
Or in an accident. Trust the Olive Law Firm, proudly serving the Carolinas since 1957.
In today's economy, your image is more important than ever. Make the most of your first impression. Tri-County Printing Solutions is a full-service print shop right here in Western North Carolina. With on-site equipment and expert staff, we are able to print, cut, mount, and prepare all your custom sign and graphic needs. With personal service, fast turnaround, quantity discounts, no minimums, no setup or layout fees, we will meet your needs. Take your business to the next level with Tri-County Printing Solutions.
Hungry and just looking for old-fashioned diner food? Then come to the way things used to be. Located at the NC Music Factory, this fully restored 1950s diner was literally relocated from New Jersey and served some of the best food in town. Our menu includes breakfast that is served all day, burgers, sandwiches, and dinner entrees. Don't leave without tasting our homemade desserts or one of our milkshakes, the best in Charlotte. Our motto is good food with attitude. So no matter if you come early or late night, at Maddie's Diner, you're always family.
Or in an accident, trust the Olive Law Firm, proudly serving the Carolinas.
And we are back live here in Charlotte at Fight Lab 45 at the Grady Cole Center. I'm Corey Von Eggen. To my left, Joseph Pacheco, Bellator veteran. What's going on, Joe? You ready for the main card?
Oh, absolutely. I'm ready for the main card, man. I can't wait for it to start off. Had a little ruckus over there in the crowd. Got taken care of thanks to Cornbread.
Wouldn't be Fight Lab without a little extracurricular ruckus.
Of course not. Kyle Martin chose a great song to walk out to today. Coming down from 8 points Muay Thai with Cliff Clockfelter as his head striking coach, we have Kyle Martin coming down.
Coming out in the typical Muay Thai attire.
Kyle Martin is sporting an unblemished 4-0 record at the young age of 20 years old, hailing out of North Carolina. Making his second appearance and title contention right here in the Fight Lab cage again. Last time he was in here, he had a unanimous decision against Sheldon Sales. In January, winning all three rounds, 29-28. Once again, coming out with his traditional Muay Thai attire. Kyle Martin sporting a nice tattoo that says determined across his back. Once again, this young man is 20 years of age fighting for a title. It is surprising me at the age these guys are starting to come out and making title contenders in the area.
Bring me John Heaney.
John Henning's born a 5-4 record. A little upside down does not reflect the fighter he is currently. He started off his career 0-2. And it's turned that back around in the last two years, and become pretty, pretty dominant. His last fight was over Rodney Jordan. I remember that one. It was the third round. I think Rodney Jordan went for a low kick and
hurt his leg.
Yep. Yeah. Okay. And John checked it. John is pretty proficient at his kicks as well. So this would be a very, very interesting dynamic fight seeing these two strikers go at it. There's the last person to beat John Henning is actually Jared Miller. Jared Miller comes from an extensive background in wrestling, which can try and nullify what John Henning does. I just don't see that happening today from Kyle Martin. It doesn't look in his attire that he's ready to take anything down to the ground. This should be a back and forth brawl between two great strikers. So Corey, tell me what goes to your mind right now as you're getting Vaseline'd up right before you get into the cage.
I gotta tell you, man, I'll get a little bit of anxiety and stuff leading up to a fight. A couple weeks out's the worst, but it all goes away when I get to walk down that runway, get to get my clothes off, get greased up. That's the most confident I am the entire time. When I step into the cage, it's go time. I mean, there's nothing else. All I'm thinking about at that point is getting my breath right. You know, I want to slow my heart rate down as much as I can. I really focus on breathing in through my nose and just relaxing, slowing that heart rate down, because you know it's going to be pump, 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 pump.
Absolutely.
Title fight of the evening, is that correct?
No, it is not.
Second title fight of the evening. Second of three. I would assume we're about to see a stand-up match here. I could be very wrong, though. What do you think, Joe?
I totally agree with you. Like I said before, these guys don't typically look like grapplers. I know for a fact that John Henning does not really care to grapple. He'd rather keep it standing if all possible. That's where he's more comfortable at. So it's going to be a very, very exciting fight.
Both guys filling each other out in the middle of the ring to start.
Kyle coming out with that nice, powerful kick out first. John testing out the waters. Jab getting his range down.
Oh, nice.
Kyle's not afraid to throw those kicks. Comes in hard every time. There's literally no fear in that young man's face.
Goes that kick again. That's the third body kick we've seen. Both guys exchange leg kicks.
Oh, absolutely. Nice trade off there. Martin has a very, very good head movement.
Oh, there we go.
Barely
that's our first takedown of the evening.
John Henning has a half butterfly, keeping Kyle pinned down. Not a lot going on there. Pretty much hold him down, not wanting to give space up for good reason. Kyle Smith's very, very quick.
Kyle relaxed, trying to soften him up, working the body, working the head. Back to the body, back to the head. Both fighters relaxed, under control. John Henning keeping a tight, close guard. Neither fighter really working too hard to improve position right here.
No.
As soon as I say that, John Henning goes for a, throws that leg over.
Can't see from this angle what he's going for on that far side. But Kyle Martin is pretty much staying stuck on his hip. Not trying to give any space.
He's on the right side of the card. So he would have been a blue card.
Kyle Martin now in Phoenix half guard. Still trying to soften him up with body shots. Again, neither fighter looking to do anything crazy here.
Henning looking to push that knee, try to create some space, maybe get for an escape right here. But he has let go of that head. Right now, all he's doing is having that head hook, just keeping it pinned down on top of him. These guys have to realize that these are four-minute rounds, not three-minute rounds anymore, and they have five of them.
Henning gets it back to full guard, controlling Martin's head from the bottom. Martin still trying to soften him up with little shots. Henning puts his left foot in Martin's hip, back to full guard. Throws a leg over, looks like he's got a triangle right here.
But no arm, it's just a naked triangle. And it's tight. I'm not sure he can finish it here because it's not enough space.
And he's not going to.
It wasn't constricted enough off of either arteries. Oh. Now he's in a bad position. Martin with a nice hard right to the sternum, to the step. Oh man, he's in bad position right here. Henning had to move quickly.
Henning got out of there quick.
Into a half guard, almost locked down position, or locking down the half guard. Martin is staying in really, really good position, not putting himself in bad position at all. And that is in the first round.
So Kyle Martin takes that round without a doubt.
Oh, absolutely. Yeah. That was a good-looking round. Kind of surprised that Kyle Martin went for that takedown, even though when he scored it, it was in great position. Great first round. I'm expecting to see some very, very similar things. If I was Kyle Martin's corner, I would tell him to do exactly what you just did. And if I was a John Henning's corner, we have the pressure. We have to keep him honest. The moment he can close that gap and take us down is when we're losing.
Absolutely. Kyle Martin looked great that first round. Slow and methodical. There was a method to his madness. He landed a couple good shots from the top.
John is doing very good with that jab. He's getting in with that deep kick.
Oh, still stuffs that takedown pretty easy with double underhooks right there.
Oh, absolutely. Kyle Martin came in looking like a 757, arms wide out, elbows all the way up. It was very, very easy for John Henning to stick both double unders up and suck him right back up to his feet.
John Henning not working too hard to get off the cage here. He needs to jack up that left underhook, turn to his left. Guys fighting position. Kyle Martin drops down for a double. He's going to look to suck him back off the cage.
Nice change.
And there
levels.
He goes. I want to see him posture up and rain down some shots right here.
Kyle Martin is showing great versatility here. It's not that often where you see a guy in traditional Muay Thai shorts pin somebody against the cage, drop down with a level change, going for a double leg, and actually scoring it.
This is true. I'd like to see him posture up here a little bit or even stand up and pinch his legs and rain down some shots.
Absolutely.
Right
now, I think Kyle's playing it safe by staying tight and just hitting those rapid punches. Right now, he's in no immediate danger. I think at this point, he's totally comfortable with taking these rounds just by doing what he's doing right now.
And I'm going to tell you right now, from my view right here, Joe, I can see John Henning talking to Kyle Martin from the bottom position. I don't know what he's saying because he's getting punched in the face repeatedly, but he's saying something.
Can't be anything
throws
good.
That leg over, goes for another triangle attempt. This is the third time we've seen this tonight. He's got an arm in this time, Joe.
Absolutely. Good reposition, get an angle. Kyle Martin's letting him get up that angle. You see how he's bowed over? If John Henning can get to his foot, he's in deep trouble here.
He's got that tight. The arms across. He's got it tight.
Martin trying to stop it up. And the tap! Talking about changing the dynamic of a fight. Kyle Martin dominating the whole first round. Minor tweaking by his professor right there. John Piper, his jiu-jitsu coach over there at East Coast Fighter.
You can tell Kyle's disappointed in himself. He knows he was in great position. He's winning the fight. Got caught there.
Absolutely. Absolutely. You cannot discredit that because he was going after something.
That was the third triangle attempt for John Henning. Third time paid off.
That was a great job adjusting in between rounds to lock in that submission victory.
What?
Once again, coming back from almost an upside-down record. He started off his career as 0-2, made the change to East Coast Fighter, and has become a very, very dominant fighter in the featherweight division.
In today's economy, your image is more important than ever. Make the most of your first impression. Tri-County Printing Solutions is a full-service print shop right here in Western North Carolina. With on-site equipment and expert staff, we are able to print, cut, mount, and prepare all your custom signing.
I don't know who won that one. What says... No, I think the Bia won that one.
The Bia won that one. Champion, John. Long MMA journey to a title. Long Fight Lab journey to the Fight Lab title. How are you feeling right now?
I'm ecstatic. Dream come true. I've fought for like 5-6 times now. So let's get the fight for the title and then bring the belt home.
Now, over the years since I've known you, the biggest hiccup or complaint on you or strike against you was, you know, you're a phenomenal striker, you move good, but your grappling's never been up to par. Now, I see some grappling royalty right there in your corner, Professor John Piper. How much did you guys work on that triangle? Because I saw you going after it a couple times.
I mean, not necessarily the triangle, that's my thing. That's probably my best bowling ground, but I spent probably more time on the ground this game than I had in there. So, Piper's bringing me along.
Anybody do a thing?
I want to thank Crew, Piper, Van Gogh, everybody else on East Coast Fighter for working with me. My family, my girlfriend, Natalie. Also, the Del Montoya, the Silverfly.
Helping
get
in
here tonight.
And
I think that's about
it.
So, think that's about
everybody.
No, I don't need him.
Ladies and gentlemen, a man of very few words.
Oh, you got
the
game?
Yeah, I can. When I leave, I catch him home. Your new champion, Akuma John Heaney!
Needs with personal service, fast turnaround, quantity discounts, no minimums, no setup or layout fees. We will meet your needs. Take your business to the next level with Tri-County Printing Solutions.
Hungry and just looking for old-fashioned diner food? Then come to Maddie's Diner. Maddie's Diner is a neighborhood diner that transports you back in time so you can enjoy remembering the way things used to be. Located at the NC Music Factory, this fully restored 1950s diner was literally relocated from New Jersey and serves some of the best food in town. Our menu includes breakfast that is served all day, burgers, sandwiches, and dinner entrees. Don't leave without tasting our homemade desserts or one of our milkshakes, the best in Charlotte. Our motto is good food with attitude. So no matter if you come early or late night, at Maddie's Diner, you're always family.
Title fight of the night.
Absolutely. And making his way down the catwalk right now is Tony Gravely. Tony Gravely has an extensive wrestling background. He's an All-American wrestler who, out of Cornbread's mouth, is coached by Cornbread. He comes from Tech MMA out of Virginia, sporting a good record of 3-1. Once again, that's just sanctioned fights. In Virginia, you have unsanctioned fights, where there's a possibility where you can have four fights in that if it is not recorded by the national database. Tony Gravely, I had a chance to talk to him earlier today. He's a very, very humble, very, very soft-spoken young man.
God,
very
I love respectful. That. I love the bantamweight division, Joe, and I love good wrestlers in the bantamweight division.
Well, there's a good chance you're going to see both of those tonight. Because when I talked to Tony about his opponent, he just said his opponent he believes is a grappler. Ready to have a good grapple match and also throw hands with him. Not shying away from the fact that he's ready to throw hands. Comes Billy Alexander, sporting a 4-0 unblemished record from Hickory, North Carolina, representing SMA and Carroll Brothers BJJ, fighting for all to see. Gravely wins all his matches by submission. He's already a title holder at 4-0. Billy Alexander, once again, coached by Roger Carroll and Joey Carroll from SMA and Carroll Brothers Jiu-Jitsu. Once again, Fight Lab 45, 6-year anniversary. So far, the car has been great. Not a dull moment yet. Alexander actually holds has held the title for Hard Play since his second fight of last year. This is going to be a really, really good test for Billy Alexander.
This young man comes to us from Hickory, North Carolina. This he has an unblemished, undefeated record of 4 wins versus no defeats. Representing Team Superior MMA, Charlotte, put your hands together for Billy
This has to be one of the youngest fight cards in Fight Lab history.
Right. On paper, who do you see winning this, Joe?
On paper, I have to go with Tony Gravely. Only 2 years senior to Billy Alexander, but you cannot ignore the NCAA All-American.
You can't do it. You can't ignore it.
No, it's hard to say so. And they're both grapplers.
How quick are we going to see a takedown attempt by Gravely?
I think it's going to be a feel-out point. I don't think Gravely's – I think Gravely can take him down at any time he chooses to.
And there he goes.
A big whip.
There's that double leg.
When you rear back like that, you leave yourself open for any type of takedown like that.
Ooh. Quick submission attempt from bottom by Alexander, looking for that armbar. Gravely needs to be careful with that.
Oh. And I think he's out. Oh, my goodness. I have never in all of my body seen somebody go out like that.
He's dangerous, dude.
That goes to show you have to know when to bail out in a submission. You have nothing protecting yourself. And Gravely did exactly what he was supposed to do. Did it look vicious? Absolutely it did. But he had every opportunity to let go of that arm to protect himself. And he did not, and it cost him the fight. He knocked himself out with Gravely picking him up like that.
That was impressive. Wow.
Once again, Tony Gravely made quick work. Very, very quick work. This canvas is unforgiving. You want to talk about just malice and...
That was malicious.
No regard.
Wow.
If you look at Billy Alexander's face right now, you would think it was a slugfest. But Tony Gravely didn't throw one punch, and he had swollen his eye up with just that slam by itself.
Legs are shaking.
Oh, absolutely. There was nothing protecting him. He was carrying his weight as well as Tony Gravely's weight. It is not very often you see somebody nasty.
I'm speechless almost. That was one of the most impressive things I've ever seen in MMA.
Absolutely. Billy Alexander came with every intention of winning, but it was simple mistakes as just holding on. There's nothing wrong with having a great jiu-jitsu background, but there are times where you have to bail out and protect yourself. As aggravated as this sounds, I am, I kind of am. I mean, that's a great job by Tony Gravely. Do not get me wrong, that is an excellent job. After slamming him the first time, readjusting the rear back and then plant his face directly on the mat. Malice and ill intent.
Malice in his heart. That was awesome. Wow.
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 Ladies and gentlemen, 27 seconds into the first round, your winner by knockout and new 135 pound champion, Tony Gravely!
Ladies and gentlemen, do not forget that name. You will see this man.
That was absolutely incredible.
Tell us, you want to thank anybody out there?
Back again at Fight Lab 45. Now about to start into our pro card. We actually have Wayne Martin coming in the middleweight division. Wayne Martin is making his pro debut. Wayne Martin was sporting a 5-0 unblemished amateur record, stepping into the cage at 30 years young and his pro debut. Fighting out of Team Rock, Harrisburg, North Carolina. Wayne Martin comes from a kickboxing background and is learning his ground game from his instructor Snake up there at Gracie Baja and Team Rock ROC. And coming to the ring, cut to the cage now, 3-0, Jeremy Holloway, unblemished pro record. Fighting out of the dark side of MMA. Jeremy Holloway is actually moving up from welterweight to middleweight to take this fight. He usually fights at 155 and 170. The reason for him jumping up to this weight class, not a clue.
And jumping up in weight class is not really a recommended avenue to do. Your body's so used to fighting at the top tier of the weight class below that when you step up, these guys that you're stepping up against are cutting 15 or 20 pounds to make their weight.
Oh, absolutely. The thing that kind of blows my mind, I've seen Jeremy Holloway fight at 155 before. For him to come in and fight 30 pounds heavier at 185 blows my mind. The logic behind it, no clue. Unless he truly believes that he can dominate this fighter at this weight. Jeremy Holloway also comes from a striking background. Just a well-rounded striker. He started off as a boxer, but it's morphed into an all-around striker. Loves a short-range offense, knees, elbows, dirty boxing. That's what he takes his pride in. When I asked him about his opponent, he told me he knows that his opponent comes from a kickboxing background, but he questions a lot of things about his opponent. He said he researched him, he looked at his past opponents, and there was nobody of any recognition that he has fought. He questions Wayne Martin's gas tank and knows that he is going to be the biggest challenge that's ever stepped in front of Wayne Martin. Even though Jeremy Holloway's up two weight classes, he still looks like he's in phenomenal shape.
Yeah, he still looks the bigger of the two opponents.
Fighting out of the red side of the gate, wearing the buying trucks trimmed in white, He stands 6 foot tall, weighing in at 185 pounds. He is undefeated in the cage at 3-0, representing the dark side of the MMA.
If you want to talk about a smorgasbord of talent in the corner, if you look at Wayne Martin's corner, you see Jeremy Perdue and Jordan Rinaldi. Both guys have very, very extensive MMA backgrounds. Both great, very, very talented. But if you look at Holloway's corner, you see Ricky Richard Rady and his coach, Jeff Jimmo. Both guys are great striking coaches, as well as Jeff Jimmo's a black belt in Brazilian Jiu-Jitsu. I have a really good feeling this is going to be fireworks from the start.
Yeah, being two bigger opponents, heavy hands can come into play and end this fight quick.
Absolutely. Where Jeremy Holloway looks a lot more clean and cut up, Wayne Martin seems to be bigger and denser just by looking at it here live in front as cage side.
Seems extremely relaxed.
Oh, absolutely. Wayne Martin is no stranger to striking. He's been kickboxing majority of his life. And I cannot imagine him taking this fight any lightly at all. So far, I've been feeling each other out, pushing, circling, both being very, very disciplined, keeping their hands up in close range. Holloway's very, very mobile, throwing really, really big.
Both the odds doing an excellent job of staying just outside of range on strikes and kicks.
Nice exchange right there. Both guys very respectful of each other's power. Wayne Martin with the big right hook, looking for a spinning back fist. Holloway with the little check kick. Wayne Martin, a true left-handed fighter. Holloway tries to mimic that left hand, that unorthodox style. Holloway, I think, is doing a great job of staying mobile, not really letting Wayne set his feet at all. And nice takedown. Wayne immediately with the elbows. Holloway looking to creep up against the cage, keep him pinned against the cage. Using that head to keep him down.
And it's this point in the fight that a lot of spectators, they see this, they think it's a lull in motion in the fight, but actually this is a very intricate and detailed part of the sport. You know, there you get control of your opponent without being hit and try to get back to your feet.
Oh, absolutely. In the top position, you're trying to get the man on bottom to carry your weight and immobilize him while still trying to strike as safely and effectively as possible. Now on bottom, on the other hand, you're trying to soften him up to give you some space, whether to get out or try to pop up a submission. It's a chess game at this point. Very, very small moves, very, very small increments mean a lot in this positioning.
Both men are doing an excellent job of neutralizing each other's.
And we're seeing a lot of the same things as they were standing up, both kind of just neutralizing, not really going one way or the other.
I think the bottom man is just trying to hold on and see if he can't get it stood back up to his feet.
Absolutely. I wonder how long they're going to sit here and actually hold this position before the ref stands him up. And Jeremy Holloway, obviously, doesn't like to be held on. And once again, the ref makes a good decision, standing back up. Nice quick hook by Jeremy Holloway. Oh, big overhand left. I'm not sure if it connected or if it was actually caught. But a big loop in hand.
Oh,
nice spinning back kick.
Good spinning back kick right into the gut.
Wayne Martin ate that left hook right to the chin. Still pressing forward. Last 10 seconds. And Wayne Martin with his last little jump kick towards the end and a last-ditch effort to try and win that round. That was an extremely tough round for both guys. I'd have to give that first round to Jeremy Holloway. It was a nice back and forth in between in the rounds. But that big takedown and the big punches that were landed, I'd have to give that round to Jeremy Holloway.
Now, I'm gonna have to agree with you on that. Seemed to be faster at getting his punches off and faster at moving out of the way when the punches were thrown at him.
Absolutely, absolutely. I'm not saying that Wayne was absolutely not doing anything, but Holloway was a lot more effective in his striking and where they hit and how they hit. Both these guys are extremely comfortable standing up. Both self-proclaimed farm strikers. Nice high kick by Wayne Martin. And Jeremy Holloway returns it.
I think Holloway needs to be real careful about the number of feints he's been throwing.
Absolutely, he's keeping him moving. He's got to keep him moving. The moment that Wayne Martin sits in one spot and is able to bomb on him, might be big trouble for him. But Wayne Martin does a great job of moving laterally every time Holloway pushes forward. Nice high front kick from Wayne Martin.
Good inside leg kick.
Absolutely, the reaction time on Holloway is just. It's incredible. Holloway went for a takedown and pulled guard and then ended back on his feet. Both these guys are very, very, very athletic, very skilled practitioners of striking as well as grappling to get back to the feet so quickly. Wayne Martin with good combinations. Holloway doing a good job of moving his head out the way. Wayne Martin doing a good job of swinging big. Holloway keeps on switching his stance, changing from orthodox to unorthodox. And Wayne Martin is staying very, very disciplined in that same southpaw stance, throwing those front high kicks. Holloway is doing a very...
Oh.
Holloway is doing a very good job of keeping just outside his range and keeping that lateral movement going. Wayne Martin is really starting to slow down. That lateral movement we were talking about in the first round has slowed down tremendously. He backed straight into the cage, and Holloway let him back off of it.
Moving around, it burns a lot of energy that you don't even realize that you're using until you go to use it, and then it's just not there.
Absolutely. Hands are starting to get a little bit lower from Wayne Martin, same as Holloway. Nice step in, trying to throw those punches. Once again, switching his stance as he comes in. Holloway's doing a great job staying out. But Wayne is doing a great job of changing the different dynamics of striking. Wayne has very, very good high kicks. Jeremy Holloway starting to paw that jab out there as Wayne's still pumping him out. That was a stiff right hook. Holloway may be hurt. He's got 10 seconds. Nice recovery. I think Holloway was in danger with that left hook.
Yeah.
That was another great, great round. It's a tough one. I just can't give away a full five-minute round off of one good punch. I'm going to go with the whole package. You're talking about moving in, moving out, being dynamic, forcing the pace. I'm going to have to give that round to Jeremy Holloway again.
Now, I'm wondering if Mr. Holloway is setting back for this third and final round because he's not been as aggressive moving forward. So I'm wondering if his strategy is to come out this third round and just try to open up.
Absolutely. So it'd be good to see how they both decide to come out. They're both coming out strong. I think Wayne knows he's coming out that he has to win big in this last round with a knockout submission. So I think he's going to push the pace extremely as much as he can.
And so far he's getting off the faster and the better the punches. Good stiff jabs.
Holloway, good left hood, left hand by Holloway. Both these guys are still going after it. Wayne's doing a great job of finally cutting the ring off on Holloway. And Wayne moves back for the first time in the cage for this round. Holloway still being very dynamic.
Good head kick.
Holloway still pressing. If you watch right now how Holloway's controlling the center of that cage. Whereas early in the round, Wayne was really cutting the cage off every time he moved laterally. But Wayne's lost a lot of bounce in his step. He's become really lethargic. If you notice, he's almost Frankensteining back and forth every time he steps. Eating another big hand. Nice check hook by Wayne. Holloway still being the aggressor, though. Nice exchange. Both guys came in. I think Holloway walked away with that, with the better of that exchange, though. Great head move by Holloway. But Wayne showing great versatility. Firing back. Both have something to prove in this third round. Holloway is still the more agile and mobile fighter right now. Wayne's starting to sit down a little bit deeper in his stance. I'm wondering if a power kick or something powerful is coming right here. Pop.
And Martin's really got to start opening up on this. If he, in my opinion, if he wants to win this fight, he's going to have to open up and just let it all go in this last round.
Oh, absolutely. But you got to think how much he has left.
I mean, I don't.
I don't believe Wayne has been pushed to this point in his fights before. Mm-hmm. And this goes to say what Jeremy Holloway said in his pre-fight interview, that he questioned his gas tank. And right now it seems to be that was a good guess or a good estimate to question that. He's shown big signs of fading. Nice jump spinning back kick. And nice takedown. That was a good job by Jeremy Holloway. I don't know how hurt he was, but I know he stumbled back into that cage. Came back out, Wayne Mark came in for the kill, and all he did was change levels and go for that takedown and solidified that exchange.
Now, Mark can't just sit here and just hold Holloway in this position, hoping that the referee's going to stand him back up. I don't believe he has time to sit there without luxury.
No, absolutely not. And Holloway is still being active. He's still moving. He's just not giving up any space. They're all short punches. But they still do count. Wayne Mark trying to short elbows and short punches. He's back against the cage as Holloway tries to drive into him. 10 seconds left. I just don't think Wayne has anything or any time left to get anything out of it. At that point in the fight, I think Wayne Martin is obviously frustrated, mad because Holloway was holding him there. At that point in the fight, you cannot be mad at your opponent. You should have did more.
No, no.
To try and finish that fight off while you're still standing.
No, he had two other rounds to attempt to end this fight. But waiting for the last 10 seconds and then getting upset about it. I mean, if y'all be pointing back at true or false.
Oh, absolutely not. That was a mental break for Wayne Martin. It was definitely a tough fight. I don't see any round that he could have won that fight, unfortunately for Wayne Martin. Once again, that was a great stand-up fight, back and forth. Unfortunately, I just don't think Wayne Martin did enough to win that fight. Once again, these guys actually trained together a couple times, so I'm not too sure that there's a lot of bad blood in between them, but it's obvious frustration that Wayne Martin showed. Once again, like I said, the first round may have been a push, but the last two rounds definitely with Jeremy Holloway.
Practices of its kind, deeply dedicated to protecting the rights of people injured by the negligence of others, the Olive Law Firm has proudly served the Carolinas for over 50 years with excellence and integrity, providing individual, personalized attention to the specifics of each case. Our areas of practice include serious personal injury, workers' compensation, wrongful death, automobile accidents, unpaid overtime wages, brain and spinal injuries, slip and fall, truck accidents, product liability, dog bites, immigration, disability, simple divorce, and police misconduct. And there is never a charge for your initial consultation. If you or someone you love has been injured at work or in an accident, trust the Olive Law Firm, proudly serving the Carolinas since 1957.
In today's economy, your image is more important than ever. Make the most of your first impression. Tri-County Printing Solutions is a full-service print shop right here in Western North Carolina. With on-site equipment and expert staff, we are able to print, cut, mount, and prepare all your custom sign and graphic needs. With personal service, fast turnaround, quantity discounts, no minimums, no setup or layout fees, we will meet your needs. Take your business to the next level with Tri-County Printing Solutions.
Hungry and just looking for old-fashioned diner food? Then come to Maddie's Diner. Maddie's Diner is a neighborhood diner that transports you back in time so you can enjoy remembering the way things used to be. Located at the NC Music Factory, this fully restored 1950s diner was literally relocated from New Jersey and serves some of the best food in town. Our menu includes breakfast that is served all day, burgers, sandwiches, and dinner entrees. Don't leave without tasting our homemade desserts or one of our milkshakes, the best in Charlotte. Our motto is good food with attitude. So no matter if you come early or late night, at Maddie's Diner, you're always family.
Disability, simple divorce, and police misconduct. And there is never a charge for your initial consultation. If you or someone you love has been injured at work or in an accident, trust the Olive Law Firm, proudly serving the Carolinas since 1957. As one of the first law practices of its kind, deeply dedicated to protecting the rights of people injured by the negligence of others, the Olive Law Firm has proudly served the Carolinas for over 50 years with excellence and integrity, providing individual, personalized attention to the specifics of each case. Our areas of practice include serious personal injury, workers' compensation, wrongful death, automobile accidents, unpaid overtime wages, brain and spinal injuries, slip and fall, truck accidents, product liability, dog bites, immigration, disability, simple divorce, and police misconduct. And there is never a charge for your initial consultation. If you or someone you love has been injured at work or in an accident, trust the Olive Law Firm, proudly serving the Carolinas since 1957.
In today's economy, your image is more important than ever.
Make it a banner play. TJ A-Rod at the fourth quarter, bringing me Joseph Manns.
Welcome back to Fight Lab 45.
And we are back. Joseph Manns from Salvation MMA. Joseph Manns sporting a 4-0 pro record. 23 years old, fighting at 155. In his whole career, he has yet to lose a fight. Oh, he has definitely been down this road for quite some time. He's been fighting since 2011, which is 4 years ago, which means he started off at a very, very young age. Started fighting at 155 and now fights at 145. Joseph Manns is actually fighting out of Kentucky. It's going to be a really, really good battle that's about to happen right now. And walking out right now, we have Cody the Juice Box Gully, also sporting a 4-0 pro record. He is 21 years of age and has been training MMA for the last 5 years of his life. Coming from Triple G Outreach, he has a background in boxing and in wrestling. When I asked about what he thought of his opponent, what he knew about his opponent, he said he knows his opponent is a gritty, straightforward fighter. See, he's really looking forward to this fight. Cody Gold is a young man who actually thrives off of a good challenge. And he's going to get that tonight in Joseph Manns.
I believe both these men are coming into this fight tonight with perfect 4-0 records. How do you think that affects them mentally coming into this, knowing that one of them has to walk out of here with a loss on their record?
I believe with both these guys' extensive records and how they've been on a win streak their whole entire career, I really do believe that they both think that they're going to be, you know, they're going to walk out this with still unblemished. They both come into the cage really visualizing themselves walking out with the zero still on one side of this, on the one side of the record. Once again, but both these guys are super, super young and have been fighting for quite some time, even though Cody Gulley is only 21 years of age. He is very, very experienced inside that cage. Right, expect to see fireworks here, guys. Neither one of these guys are coming in with any expectation of losing this fight today.
Yeah. Mane is coming in looking like he's the more physically fit of the two.
Oh, Cody Gulley still haven't stepped into his man strength yet. He's still a child at the tender age of 21. But Mans is really manhandling him right now.
Good short right.
Nice changeup. Good head movement from Gulley. Mans still on the prowl, pushing forward. Straight punches, using that jab. And that unorthodox stance that he has. Man's actually with an unintentional eye jab.
And one thing Juice Box is doing is he's circling to the right with the, I guess, the southpaw. He's leading himself right into that straight left hand.
Absolutely, which is not very good. In any aspects, you don't want to walk into his power unless he's been training for a certain setup to do that.
Good body shot.
Cody Gulley seems pretty unfazed by that nice body shot. Good change up to that head kick. Neither one of these guys are afraid to step into the pocket and actually throw.
Good actually, nice box.
Great catch by Mans. But also great defense by Gulley. Juice Boxer, good head movement. Oh, that was a great, great overhand by Mans. And Gulley looking for the takedown. Once again, Gulley showing off his wrestling background from Strong in the days of Strong Courageous. Up, see a little cut over the right eye of Gulley. Gulley in for the takedown, but Mans is able to pull him up and off and actually gets a reversal and gets Gully's back against the cage. Now Mans trying to soften up those knees. Mads is doing a great job of faking. But that head movement of Cody Gulley.
Yeah, Gulley got some good head movement. The only thing he's doing is when he's moving his head, he's moving it outside of his hands. So it's unprotected while it's being moved.
Absolutely. He's not able to throw from that position if he's just moving his head, just like you just said. You have to keep your hands with your head if you actually expect to throw off of that. Uh-huh. Nice head kick by Mans.
Good takedown defense by Manus.
Cody Gulley is expending a lot of energy looking for that takedown. Mans leaning really hard. Now Mans looking for the takedown on Cody. Mans gets the legs out.
Switch.
Cody goes for a switch and reverses it, but not able to finish it there. Mans push away, straight left. And go with that leaping jab. Oh, nice right hand. And now Mans wants to go, steps back to orthodox. Good transition, good level change. Mans goes for the takedown and is actually able to keep him down this time. Both these guys are very, very, very versed in grappling. Going for takedowns, even though he scores it, not able to keep going down. Wow, I cannot believe it's been 5 minutes already.
No, this has been a very interesting back and forth match.
Absolutely. And that's time.
Don't forget, Carolina is in the house.
I would have to walk away with that one and give that one to Mans. Mans landed the most damage, did the best he could, but oh man. That round right there was all Mans. Cody did a great job of being defensive, trying to be elusive, good head movement. But Mans was just too much for him in that round.
Heels.com if you love fashionable women's shoes. The ease of buying online, check out Heels.com. They're providing the footwear for the Fight Lab ring girls and all the female staff. The latest fashionable footwear. Check them out online at Heels.com. How about the Fight Lab after fight party? Maverick Rock Taco. The after fight party.
And here we go as Gully's corner tries to clean up that little bit of spill off the canvas. Oh, and Gully's about to start that round without a mouthpiece.
That would not be a wise decision.
At all. Gully finally checks those kicks.
Good uppercut.
Yes, it was. Gully did a great job of sucking that leg back in, but not able to finish it.
It's like Manus is using a little more fluidity while Juicebox is more power-oriented.
Oh, absolutely. Right now, but Manus just too strong. Anytime they get into that close vicinity, and Juicebox is in deep on these leg attacks. All Mad does is reach down, gets his underhooks, and actually gets him right back up. Once again, deep in on the double leg, and Mad is just able to pull him up without having any problems whatsoever.
I know his main is playing with his mouthpiece.
Yeah, it's going up and down. He hadn't paid for it yet. Once again, Cody a deep, nice takedown. He has to secure it. And Mans gets back up again. But Cody takes up. Oh, no. I really hate to say this, but I really think that Mans has too much man strength for Cody. Cody's just not coming to his prime of physical strength, that is.
I agree with that.
Nice transition by Gully, though. Tries to lock up the guillotine. The man slides right out of it. Man's doing a great job of keeping a great position as they're trading. Nice jab. I think at this point in the fight, Mans knows that Cody can't really answer him standing up. That's why he's going for those desperate shots.
Yeah, he keeps trying for those takedowns. He's unable to get him, which has burned through a lot of his energy. He can step back and regroup and maybe rethink his game plan.
Absolutely.
A body kick. Bod, return, body kick.
And Gully tries to go for a lat drop, but unsuccessful.
Woo! They ride into a guillotine.
And puts himself into a guillotine. And then puts himself right back into it after escaping it. What is Cody thinking right here? Mans doesn't have a good position as he tries to reach back through. Softens the body up while he still has the head hooked. Gully looking to finally finish it as Mans flattens him back out. And Gully does a nice shift and shear to get out. Nice high-low striking there and go for another takedown. And Mans locks up the guillotine.
Good knee to the face.
Gully's going back for a leg attack there. I think that's out of desperation. He just doesn't know what to do at this point.
Yeah, so far everything he's done has been stopped. I'm going to put it right back into his face. Try to throw combinations. He gets combinations thrown back at him. He tries for a takedown to get stopped. Mentally, that must be wearing on him.
Absolutely. Even though Gully's still continuing the pressure.
Good double knee by Manus.
And it's just teeing off on Cody right now. Cody's stuck in that position.
Manny's doing an excellent job of just putting his body weight onto Juice Box, making him work off of that.
Absolutely. It's unfortunate, man. Juice Box is one of my favorite young fighters right now. And I'm not used to seeing him just get this dominated. Even though he's still fighting, it's just as simple as that. This has been mentally taxing for Juice Box at this point. And once again, in that round, I have to give that round to Mans.
Yeah, Mans too many dominated that.
At no point in time was he ever in danger at any point in time in that fight.
Third and final round.
Last round, and Cody Juicebox Gully looks worse for wear.
Be interested to see if he abandons the takedown part on this third and final round.
I don't know. He's getting teed off on right now. There's not many punches that man is throwing that are not landing. Nice hip over for Cody Gully. And Juicebox finally in a dominant position here. Gotta continue to go, gotta continue to move there.
Juice Box really needs to posture up and start trying to land some bigger blows. This third and final round, he's not going to be able to win this off this round alone.
No. Man's doing a great job of keeping him sealed off. Those little rabbit punches are not going to finish his fight off. They have to keep it up. Man's right now just holding on, not letting him posture up, trying to eliminate as much space as he can, keeping that butterfly hook inside. Create some space to come back underneath.
We're trying to step over triangle.
I don't. Maybe he felt comfortable in that position. I just don't. It might have been desperation. It's really hard to tell there. I just thought that made no sense.
Yeah, I wasn't exactly sure what he was trying for.
As man holds on, Cody Gulley tried to reset. Right now it looks like Mans is just holding on.
Yeah.
Doing just enough to keep from breaking against the cage. And Cody is really, really, really trying to push. As Cody goes, he's dropping those elbows. Man with strong foot stomps. Finally goes for the takedown and actually lands it. Cody gets back to his feet. Looks for that reset. And looks like he's trying to turn that Kimura up underneath him. But Man steps up and reverses it. Looks he's going to be going for the armbar. Mans is in deep on this armbar positioning. Can't tell from this angle. Oh, it's still sitting deep. Oh, man. Cody's trying to manipulate as much as he can to get out. And he does. That is a great show of heart right there. Cody's in a good dominant position once again. With a rear naked choke, he can finish it right here. This could be a total upset and turn.
I'm not sure if Zuzbach has the energy left to finish this off.
This has turned out to be an amazing third round. And we said that Juice Box had to do something big to finish this round, and it slipped out.
Excellent heart shown by both men.
I don't know how much time is left in the round, but Juice Box is really, really driving to try and finish this fight. Juice Box softening up, looking to go for that rear naked once again. But Man's doing a great job. He's covering up. 10 seconds left. I don't know if he has enough time to do it. Man's going to hold on. And what a finish to the fight.
That has probably been the best back and forth fight of the night so far.
Absolutely. You want striking, there was striking. You want grappling, there was grappling. Anything you could ask for was all culminated in that fight. Both these young men did an excellent job of laying everything out on the line and pushing forward. It'll be interesting to see how this fight goes. We've had a few split decisions tonight that shouldn't have been split decisions, so we'll see how this one turns out.
Yeah, I think this is going to be a pretty unanimous decision on this. I mean, the third round, the juice bottle looked real good at the end of the third round, but the first two rounds just wasn't enough to cover that.
I can only see this being a 29-28 fight, bar none.
Ladies and gentlemen, how about a hand for those two warriors?
And both these young men.
We go to the judges' scorecards. Judge number one scores it 29-28. Judge number two scores it 29-28. Judge number three scores it 29-28. Your winner by unanimous decision, Joseph Mayhem Maynard!
And Joseph Maynard, age of 23 years old, this young man has improved himself to 5-0 in his pro record, still undefeated in his MMA career.
Yeah, this could be a big learning step for Juicebox if he wishes to take it as that, or it could be a mental barrier for him.
At the age of 21, I can't see him stopping anytime soon. It's going to have to be a learning step for him.
So they doing an intermission before this young's back on? You picked the odds? Who picked the odds on it?
Alright. If you're taping the basketball game, you might want to close your ears. With 36 seconds to go, the game is tied. 66-66, Notre Dame and Kentucky. DJ A-Rod on the blue side of the cage. Bring me the boss, Michael Stevens.
And coming to the cage right now, Michael Stevens at a 5-2 record. This young man, 25 years of age, fighting out of North Carolina. 8 points Muay Thai, Winston-Salem. just coming off another victory at Fight Lab 43 in January to an elbow, beating Lawrence Dennis. This young man, even though his record is 5-2, is very, very skilled in striking. Very versatile. As I said, he won that last fight, the elbow. He actually won due to submission, but it was brought on by the elbow he landed. Short, short elbow on the inside that dropped his opponent.
It's his opponent, Kentucky 68, Notre Dame 66. DJ A-Rod on the red side, bring me the Warhead, Willie Hooch!
And coming to the cage right now, Warhead, really hot. As you can tell, he brings one heck of a crowd everywhere he goes. Really hot, 4-1 as a pro at the welterweight division, probably from Salisbury, North Carolina, out of the dark side of MMA. As he walks down the catwalk, Willie Hotch has beaten his last two opponents, excuse me. Willie Hotch is a high-level wrestler. It's going to be very, very interesting to see how this fight goes between this great striker, Michael Stevens, and the grappler, Willie Warhead. It's not a welterweight fight, it's a 155-pound fight. It really makes that extreme cut from 170 to 155. It's definitely going to be an exciting fight.
Ladies and gentlemen,
once again, you see
fighting out of the blue side of the cage, wearing the red, gold, and black trunks. He stands 5'11". He weighed in at 158 pounds. His record, 5 wins against only 2 losses. Representing 8 points Muay Thai from Mount Airy, North Carolina, please welcome the boss, Michael Stevens. His opponent, fighting out of the red hat, wearing the black trunks trimmed in red. He stands 5'8" tall. He weighed in at 156 pounds. His record, impressive at 4 wins against only 1 loss. Representing the dark side of MMA, from Salisbury, North Carolina, please welcome the Warhead, Willie Hooch. Your referee is Larry Carter.
All right, guys, we went over the rules in the back. Everything should be clear. Fight hard, fight clean, obey my commands at all times. Any questions from either fighter? Okay, let's get this on touch close.
Here we go, Charlotte!
This is going to be exciting for the first bell. Michael Stevens is not afraid of anybody that stands in front of him. It's going to be really, really good. Nice front kick by Willie Hosh. Oh, but he made a pay. Oh! It sinks in the rear naked deep. Nice in the saddle. Still has that rear naked on tight. I just don't know if he can sink that arm behind his and lock it in. Michael Stevens not in any danger of that rear naked as of right now. Willie Hosh holds out that right hand as he rains down his right hands over top of him. Willie Hosh still has his back. As Michael Stevens tried to return some fire from off the bottom, Willie Hosh looks to posture up, maybe get into to mount position. And he does. And six in the rear naked again from mount. And gets into Michael Stevens' closed guard. Michael Stevens tries to swing around for an armbar. Willie Hodges elbow deep too much. As he softens those rib cages up. Michael Stevens seems to have locked down on that far left arm. Nice short elbow by Stevens from the bottom. Another one. Almost in the north-south position. As Stevens has that arm locked down and tries to go for an overhook. Steven does a good job of trying to block that elbow and return one of his own. Almost in a north-south position. Steven still being very active off the bottom. As Willie says, those short elbows to the body. True north-south. Now in side control. In the half guard. Half guard. Seems to have Willie in a guillotine position. He would need to lock that up. Willie needs to fight off. Good job from Willie Hosh. Steven needs to try and close that distance. Not let Willie Hosh posture up. If he lets him posture up, it's going to be bad, bad news. Steven's doing a really good job of keeping that distance closed, not letting Willie work from here, but not able to do anything from off his back either. As long as Willie stays in this position, he's gonna win the fight. Steven looked like he was going for a go-go plata. Steven staying active, trying to short strikes off his back still. Stevens trying to get an angle out on his hips. Going back for that armbar. And Willie Hosh explodes out and breaks that submission. Spins back around. Gets back on the same side. And Stevens finally gets back to his feet. Inside trip by Willie Hosh back into his guard.
And Willie is showing just complete dominance in all positions right here.
Yeah. great first rounds.
Don't forget those great sponsors like TNT Nutrition, Maddie's Diner, FightDoctor.com, HendrickCarr.com, Mastercraft Furniture.
Great fight by
these
two young men.
After fight, partner, Maverick Rock
started off with a nice stand-up game.
They're waiting for us just a few minutes.
Right after him. And ever since that point, dominated that whole first round in good position.
Yeah, I think that kind of took the wind out of his sails, getting hit and taken down immediately.
Don't get me wrong, he was in a little danger here and there, but Willie was able to reverse that and get back in a dominant position, side control, north, south, whatever he had to get to. And still able to shoot little rabbit punches, nothing too serious.
Fighters up, seconds down, ready for round number two.
Everybody's ready to battle.
Come on, Charlotte, cheer him on!
Will he be an aggressor again? Mike Stevens, he's stalking right there, looking for a high kick. And Willie spins around into a double leg. That kid is absolutely athletic and amazing. Who else could do that?
Yeah, this is a show of athleticism from his part.
Oh, my God. Went for the front kick, landed it solid, went to plant that same leg, slipped out, pivoted around, came to a double leg. But now he found himself back in trouble in that armbar positioning. Stevens has to be smart, but Willie Hosh just had... Oh, he's found his head back in. Now he's back into full guard. And Stevens once again being busy off the bottom as Willie stays in dominant position on top.
Somebody's bleeding out pretty bad.
I think it might be Warhead because it's all over Stevens' chest. Stevens very, very nasty with these elbows. Willie Hosh showing his just how powerful he is by the movements he's making. Basically ragdoll on Stevens whichever way he goes. But Stevens is unfazed. Still trying to cut that angle for that armbar. Looked like he was going for an arm choke off the bottom there.
Excellent sweep.
Now Wood is on the defensive. He's going to have to move here. He needs to watch out. He's going to be in a triangle. He's in a lot of danger right there.
Now from this position, if Willie tries to pull out, he leaves himself susceptible to the armbar. If he stays in, he's susceptible to a triangle choke.
But it looks like, I want to say it almost looks like he has the Kimura lock. He has a figure four. And he gets out and takes his back and punishes him for being in bad position. Willie Hosh sending those knees to the back of the hamstring, softening those legs up. Willie Hosh bleeding pretty bad from the nose and trying to make him pay for those high kicks. Stevens is pressuring right now.
trip.
As Willie winds up that right hand, I don't know what he's going to do from here. And Steven gets back up, starts pressuring again.
Oh.
Steven's doing a good job of blocking those takedown defenses now. You got to start questioning the gas tank, Willie Hosh. Those takedowns are becoming a lot more labor than they were in the first round.
Yeah.
Even to the point where it's unsuccessful. And Stevens continues with those short elbows every chance he gets. Striking every point he can. One thing about Stevens, he's been relentless on the attack. Any position he can. Small shots, big shots, whatever he can do. Sliding in underneath, trying to get a little separation. One knee for another between Hosh and Stevens. Hosh once again changed the levels. Looking for another takedown. Stevens pulls him back up. Separation with 10 seconds left. Stevens steps it hard for a right hand. Willie Hosh ducks his head, comes back for a takedown. And time is out.
Good second round by both men. See, at the end of it, Willie was starting to burn through his gas tank.
Absolutely. Now it's time for the third and final round. It's all about heart here. About who wants it more.
Some of our great sponsors like Satin Med Spa, TheFightDoctors.com, North Carolina, South Carolina Car Meets, Mastercraft Furniture, HendrickCar.com.
Oh, thank you.
Wallace Crawford of Mathis Fain Realty.
The funny thing about this whole break in between rounds, Stevens almost seems excited to get back in starting his third round. As Hosh has a little malfunction with the glove. Willie Hosh still striking up and down, still changing levels, still trying to be proactive.
Good body kick.
Two up. Oh!
Out of nowhere! What?
But he drops him, but he doesn't finish him. That goes to show you have to finish these fights. You just can't walk away from somebody. The ref will not stop it sometimes.
If Will is able to get his composure back, that very well may have been a very, very huge mistake.
And I think he has. Seems Willie Hosh got some of his wits about back about him.
Oh, good short elbow.
Willie Hosh is hurt. He has to move here if he wants to finish it. Oh, and he's down. And I think that's it. That is it.
And
that is it.
What a comeback.
That goes to show you sometimes heart is what it takes. He knew he was down. He did not stop one point.
That almost cost him every bit he could.
Chipped away. Wow. What a turn of events, guys. But that goes to show you have to finish every round the same way you start the first round. You cannot let up. In the sport of MMA, all it takes is one good shot to change the course of a fight.
You can see the disappointment in Willie's face. He knew he had this fight won, but that one shot, and that one shot is all it took.
You could see as he was sitting over in the corner, as the referee was on top of him, he refused to damn. He knew he had given away that fight, and that one little slip up.
Ladies and gentlemen, 1 minute, 20 seconds into the third round, your winner by knockout, the Boss, Michael Stevens!
What a great job by Michael Stevens finishing off that fight the way he did. Hats off to both young men during that fight.
Bring it down 1 second. We got our final winner from Satin Med Spa. This is for the $1,200 Cool Sculpting Fat Reduction. Taylor Fender. Come on down to the cage. You just won a $1,200 Cool Sculpting Fat Reduction. Taylor Fender.
Serving the Carolinas since 1957.
In today's economy, your image is more important than ever. Make the most of your first impression. Tri-County Printing Solutions is a full-service print shop right here in Western North Carolina. With on-site equipment and expert staff, we are able to print, cut, mount, and prepare all your custom sign and graphic needs. With personal service, fast turnaround, quantity discounts, no minimums, no setup or layout fees, we will meet your needs. Take your business to the next level with Tri-County Printing Solutions.
Hungry and just looking for old-fashioned diner food? Then come to Maddie's Diner. Maddie's Diner is a neighborhood diner that transports you back in time so you can enjoy remembering the way things used to be. Located at the NC Music Factory, this fully restored 1950s diner was literally relocated from New Jersey and serves some of the best food in town. Our menu includes breakfast that is served all day, burgers, sandwiches, and dinner entrees. Don't leave without tasting our homemade desserts or one of our milkshakes, the best in Charlotte. Our motto is good food with attitude. So no matter if you come early or late night, at Maddie's Diner, you're always family.
A-Rod, on the blue side of the cage, bring me Andrew Whitney.
Thank you.
we have Andrew Whitley headed to the cage. 10-3 out of Coconut Creek, Florida, from American Top Team. Coming off a win last year against Chino Duran. Andrew Whitley is a Titan FC veteran, having fought for Titan FC several times. Look at his way, look at him make his way right back up there into the big show. And using Keith the Rockstar Richardson as a stepping stone.
DJ A-Rod, how about on the red side of the cage you bring me the rock star, Keith Richardson!
And now we have Keith Richardson walking to the cage. 13-6, Keith Richardson. Coming into the main event of the night in his hometown. Fighting out of Modern Warrior MMA in Rock Hill, South Carolina. Also cross-training over there with Team Alpha Male in California, where he spent the last few weeks tightening up for this training camp. Keith has made it a habit in the last few fights to go out there, Team Alpha Male, to train with the cream of the crop, TJ Dillashaw, Uriah Faber, and that whole crop of talent that they have over there. And all he seems to do is continue to make himself better and better and better. That young man continues to push himself to try to be the best fighter he can be. Keith Richardson sporting those white shorts. Born in New York, fighting out of Rock Hill, South Carolina.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening for Fight Lab 45. This fight is brought to you by the Olive Law Firm, Fuel in a Bottle, Satin Med Spa, FightDoctors.com, and Carolina MMA. Charlotte, North Carolina, are you ready? Then the time is now to meet the challenger in the blue corner. This young man comes to us from Kansas City, Missouri, fighting by way of Coconut Creek, Florida. He carries an impressive MMA record of 10 wins versus only 3 defeats. Representing the world-famous American Top Team, give it up for the beast, Andrew Whitney! And now, let's meet the young man to my right. This young man comes to us from Rock Hill, South Carolina. He has an impressive MMA record of 15 wins versus only 6 defeats. Representing Modern Warrior MMA, Charlotte, North Carolina, Rock Hill, South Carolina, give it up for the rock star, Keith Richardson!
It's obvious Keith Richardson has a huge following right here in Charlotte, North Carolina. Some people actually call him Mr. Fight Lab. Keith has actually come up with a 3-fight win streak.
Maybe
his fight or his streak going right now.
Now. This is one of the few times I've ever seen Keith being the smaller of the two opponents.
Oh, I know, and he's actually come down in weight. look like he's switching stances, being very, very agile. Still pushing forward. It's Andrew Whitley. It's kind of still, you know, getting his bearings. Nice high kick by Andrew. Return high kick by Keith. Both these two are swinging really, really big there. Even though Keith has his back against the cage, he's still being really, really dirty, really grimy. Still hanging on to the head. Reversed it. Now has Andrew Whitley against the cage. Looked for an elbow. Missed on that one. Still fighting underneath. Look, got the body lock.
Good draw.
Look, the dump behind. And it's inside control. Going to take the back. Hop inside the saddle. Did a great job of posturing back up. He was high just a few seconds ago. And Keith works his way back underneath it. Looks like he has a Kimura on the far side. Good job by Whitley getting that reverse. Big swings with those right hands on the way up.
Now Keith has a very unpredictable style of striking. Moves out to the side and throws some weird angles.
Couldn't agree more. Sometimes that style of fight leaves susceptible for some strikes. Keith switches stance back again, unorthodox. Nice high low kicks. Keith doing a good job of moving in and moving out. Keith charging back in.
And the back of Andrew's leg is also reddened up already.
Oh, absolutely. And again, same leg. Just chopping away at that tree, trying to take that explosive out that front leg. Keith's doing a great job of doing that.
Seems like Keith's really found his range. He's moving in, moving out, and being just outside of Andrew's strikes.
Absolutely. Keith's movement has improved so much by being out there by Team Alpha Male. Mm. I wonder if he picked up anything from TJ Dillashaw. Be nice to believe so. Nice mid-range kick, in and out. Good back and forth from these two. Andrew Whitley looks like he's trying to size him up before he throws something big. Nice strike, right hand. Great job getting out of the way. Keith back on the attack, having Andrews back against the cage. Pressuring hard. Setting that short knee to the thighs. Nice exchange. Andrew Whitley pushing back really hard. One thing I've noticed is that Andrew Willie's not really pressing too hard. He's picking his shots one and two, not throwing anything really big or throwing any big combinations out there just yet. Outside of maybe the first 30 seconds, everything's calmed down. It's almost like he's finding his pace right now. Nice takedown by Keith. Straight in the mount position. And somehow Whitley has reversed that. Now they're backstanding. Keith's back against cage. Nice short elbow to finish that round off by Keith Whitley. something I find very surprising at the level of Andrew Whitley. He comes all the way up here, I believe, with his girlfriend, with Tisha Torres and Tank Scoggins, with two teammates as his corner. That's one thing about having a huge team like ATT. Wherever you go, you'll know you have somebody back in your corner of high level capability.
Let's see if Andrew turns it up this round.
He's gonna have to. Nice kick again. Same kick, same leg that he's been doing the whole first round. And Whitley backs up. Let's Keith takes advantage of that. Keith seems very comfortable in either stance. And Keith goes for a Superman punch. Both disembark. Let's go.
He's doing a really good job of mixing up his attacks, low and high, and kicks.
Absolutely staying as versatile as possible. Once again, pushing back in. Nice low kick.
Good body kick.
Great body kick. Keith definitely has to do a better job of keeping his hands up. He's got clipped twice. Mm-hmm. Don't know how bad he's hurt, but you can tell it's something that they are distinguished.
Yeah, both times it's happened coming out.
Once again, nice jump towards the back. Jumps in the saddle. Looking to figure four of the body, and he does. He might be here for some time. And he has the rear naked. He has it in deep. And a tap.
Excellent job for Keith Richardson.
Spectacular finish. Another great job to finish up. Nice back and forth battle. Looked really, really good for Keith Richardson. Just as soon as you say something about him maybe being hurt, he turns back around, gets a dunk, and finishes off with a rear naked. Great execution. Another exciting night of fights here at Fight Lab. And what a way to cap it off with a finish from Keith Richardson.
Ladies and gentlemen, this bout comes to an end. 2 minutes and 5 seconds into the second round. Your winner out of the red corner by rear naked choke, the Rockstar, Keith Richardson!
All right, guys. Another great night of fights here at Fight Lab 45 on the 6-year anniversary. I'm Joe Pacheco here with Jeremiah. We're over and out.